At 62, she is a movie legend, still considered the epitome of elegance and style. When we talked, Audrey Hepburn wore little makeup, just some lipstick. Her posture is straight, her hair still shiny, that smile still electric, that voice still memorable. She starred in only 26 movies, but for the most part, they were with Hollywood's legendary directors and legendary leading men.
I only know what I know.
Taxi!
The passing years.
She stopped traffic for George Peppard.
You've kept my love so young.
I never could do that.
Easy.
She yelled at Rex Harrison.
You ought to be stuffed with nails, you ought! Here, take the old blooming basket for sixpence!
I'm so lucky.
William Holden swept her into his arms, and Humphrey Bogart swept her off her feet. She played hide-and-seek with Gary Cooper. She posed for Fred Astaire and prayed for Sean Connery. But her first big-screen love was Gregory Peck. Actually, she says she loved all of her leading men and wouldn't even try to pick a favorite.
Well, either I'm dead or I'm crazy.
You're not crazy, Pete.
And although she had been away from the screen for 9 years, her latest appearance was heavenly.
And always, why did you decide to do that with Richard Dreyfuss and Holly Hunter, where you were the wonderful angel?
Because Steven Spielberg made a phone call to me. That's why I did it. How could I resist?
Was it enough to make you want to come back in?
Well, I never left, you know, not really. Not really. I've never made great announcements. I'm retiring because it's such a bore every time you come back. I think that's very boring for people. But I'll do it again if he makes another phone call.
Last month at New York's Lincoln Center, hundreds wanted another encore. Old film flames and new film fans honored her with the Lifetime Achievement Award. And it began with her first big role in the 1951 Broadway musical Gigi. French playwright Colette knew it the minute she saw Hepburn.
And she said, would you like to do it? I said, I'd love to do it, but I can't. She said, why? I said, because I've never acted, so I don't know how to act. So I would not be able to do a play. And she said, well, you've been a dancer, so you know how to work hard, and that's all you have to do to learn to act. And that's what happened.
What also happened that same month was a search for an unknown actress to play the lead in Roman Holiday. Audrey Hepburn was 22 and recalls being terrified in front of the Hollywood director.
And he, I think, quite rightly realized how uptight I was and how nervous and how I didn't know what to do in front of a camera, which I didn't. And then he started me asking me some questions about myself, like you're doing. And that started me just talking about life and about feelings. And that was finally what got me the movie.
Within 5 years of her American screen and stage debuts, she won a Tony, an Oscar, and the New York Film Critics Award. With the flat-chested profile of a ballet dancer, Audrey Hepburn was not the typical female figure of Hollywood in the 1950s. Yet she held audiences for years with a devastating combination of innocence and sophistication, being at once a grown-up woman and adventurous child.
Won't you come in for a minute?
No, I won't.
I don't bite, you know, unless it's called for.
How would you like a spanking?
How'd you like a punch in the nose? Stop treating me like a child.
Well, then stop behaving like one. Now, if you want to tell me what's troubling you, fine. If not, I'm tired, it's late, and I want to go home to bed. Oh.
Do you know what's wrong with you?
No, what?
Nothing.
Part of that charisma is a sense of style. Designer Hubert Givenchy created her on and off-screen wardrobes.
How do I look?
However simple they are, there is always something that makes a Givenchy outfit. Maybe it's just a marvelous button, or a bow, or something. There's a lightness to his clothes. And he's also my best friend. So the two of those things for 40 years ain't bad.
And for the last 40 years, Givenchy hasn't had to change his Hepburn pattern because she still wears the same size.
I could have told you how you would be dressed today, because there is this Audrey Hepburn style.
Well, it is his style. I adore Ralph Lauren, for instance, who's to me is so pure with his country clothes and the ease, again, the simplicity. And Givenchy wears Ralph Lauren like I wear Ralph Lauren, and we all we love his things. But I couldn't live without either.
What she has lived for, though, is her private life. After shooting Wait Until Dark in 1966, she didn't make a movie for 9 years.
Why did you take a long break from movies?
Oh, but because my son had to go to school and I couldn't take him with me anymore, and I hated the idea of leaving him. And then I had a second child, and so I just did very few movies.
Her own childhood may have had something to do with that decision. Her father, a British banker, walked out on her mother, a Dutch baroness, before Audrey was 10. As the Nazis overran Europe, the Hepburns moved to Holland, thinking it would be safe. But her brother was captured and sent to a labor camp, her uncle and cousin executed. Audrey ended the war nearly starving to death.
Yeah, at the very end, there really was almost nothing to eat, and we'd spend days in bed to not use up energy, and also because it was warmer and everything. But I didn't say, ooh, I'm a starving child. We'd have great fun talking about the things we were going to have after the war, you know, like who was going to eat the biggest box of chocolates and somebody else wanted scrambled eggs or whatever it is, you know. That was a great pastime, slightly frustrating.
50 years later, she's still affected by the years of deprivation.
I'm horrified when I see food wasted. I mean, I'm obsessive about it, but it does affect me terribly, and today more than ever. I still marvel at going into supermarkets and everything. And seeing,
you like to go to supermarkets.
Shelves and shelves of everything. You know, it's still a gorgeous sight. I love supermarkets.
But television pictures of dying children in Ethiopia and those childhood memories also drove her to action. For the past 4 years, Audrey Hepburn has traveled literally around the world on a children's crusade.
Look at that, how small that is.
She is a special ambassador for UNICEF and says the children of war are the ones she wants to help the most.
Either they've already lost a limb, which we can't replace. They've lost their parents, which we can't replace. Sometimes they've lost their soul.
This winter, she toured the United States on a fundraising mission for UNICEF. That tour brought her to the Buckhead home of friend and media magnate Ann Cox Chambers. The occasion was a cocktail party for generous UNICEF donors interested in Ms. Hepburn's present and past. A second stop included dinner, where she received the Child Survival Award from former President Jimmy Carter.
And I'm especially honored to receive this beautiful gift from your hands, Mr. President, who together with Mrs. Carter are dedicating your lives, your energy, and your prayers, not only to your country, but to all of humanity.
She went on to three more states before returning home to Switzerland, where she has lived for the past 36 years.
Time after time, I tell myself that I'm so lucky.
Audrey Hepburn says she'll act again when there's time. Meanwhile, she's looking forward to becoming a grandmother.
Can't wait.
I'd love to see Audrey Hepburn as a grandmother.
Yeah, because it's a bore to look like a grandmother and then not have grandchildren. And I mean, if you have grandchildren, then it's okay. I've got to keep myself together until I am a grandmother.
But this prospective grandmotherly face reverts to that of a schoolgirl when Robert Walters enters the room. She and Robbie, as she calls him, have lived together for 7 years. He is Swiss, a former actor, who is quietly handsome and very protective.
Are you ever going to marry Mr. Walters? You two look at each other in your eyes and you glow.
Monica. Well, isn't that enough? We don't have to marry as well. We don't have to marry.
Are you afraid if we marry?
No, good Lord, no. Why should we?
Although seemingly flawless, Audrey Hepburn is not perfect. Fellow actress Shirley MacLaine says Audrey Hepburn swears. Miss MacLaine says she should know because she taught her.